When it comes to Fear of the Night, if you're someone who just wants a simple action movie showing a woman with a lot of ass without using a gun, this might be the kind of film for you. To summarize the film, Tess is a war veteran trying to maintain her sobriety, and that gets complicated by going to her sister's bachelorette party where most of the people who have been invited aren't people that she necessarily likes. Unfortunately, or fortunately, depending on how you look at it, the feeling is mutual, because most of her sister's friends think that Tess is a bit of a downer, and not just because of her sobriety, but also because her as a war veteran makes it so that maybe you can consider her PTSD, maybe, but either way, she always looks at the potential dangers of any situation she's in, which originally is very annoying and kind of ruins some of the fun. But as the bachelorette party goes on, it is what allows some people to survive the night, as this group of local thieves, under the impression that there's money in the house where the bachelorette party is happening, they decide to threaten, kill, and potentially do worse to the ladies in order to get that money. So when it comes to this film, you should know that there is cursing throughout, brutal depictions of murder. In terms of sexual content, there is depiction of candy and food that looks like genitalia because bachelorette party, but there's also threats of rape. And beyond that, there's drinking, and I don't think anyone was smoking in this movie, whether it's cigarettes or marijuana. Getting to the review section, the sole highlight is Maggie Q, and technically it's not like a strong high-level highlight. It's just her delivering what is expected, with her being one of the top, though very underutilized, action stars out there. She gives you badass woman who, because she's a soldier, of course, has a training that makes her taking on multiple men believable. Add in that she doesn't use a gun in this, instead is using random things like a rake and other things in order to kill people, or else a short knife. It gives you, if you like just watch a woman whoop ass, it gives you what you need. And add on that she's taking on misogynistic men, it ultimately delivers a satisfying but really generic hero, which leads to on-offense topics, which we're splitting into two, but really they're one and the same. And the first one is that this movie, outside of Tess, doesn't really push you to care who lives, but rather who dies and how they die. To begin, this Fear of the Night doesn't really do much in the way of character development. The only thing it really pushes is for people to say and do things that get a reaction out of you. You have one of Tess's sister's friends, despite knowing how Tess has been sober for 6 months, pushing alcohol toward her so that she'll loosen up. You have another one as things start to go bad, they start to question her military experience since she's not handling the situation. And it's stuff like that that really makes it so that when it comes to a lot of the characters who are supposed to be, you know, the victims or the people who are vulnerable, you want them to just get knocked off. And then when it comes to the villains, from what it seems, they're just poor people, potentially meth heads in some ways, and they're just trying to make a buck. And not in a way that makes you feel bad for them because they're poor, they lack opportunities, they're just men who are misogynistic, don't want to have to do anything that requires a lot of work in order to make money, perhaps, and to just try. And granted, all of this makes it so that you care more about Tess and her taking out these men and perhaps setting up some of the women to die, because she knows some of them can't do much. So a part of me does feel like she sets up one or two. Now, whether or not she really meant to or not, it's hard to say, but you can definitely tell in some parts of the movie, Tess, knowing what she knows, is definitely holding back from doing more, especially as some of them mouth off toward her. But getting to the point, unfortunately, when it comes to Fear the Night, the majority of the characters you truly don't give a damn about. Which leads into the second on-offense topic, is that there was the ever slightest chance it could have done something to make you care about certain characters. But the issue is, one of the first deaths in the movie is the person who could have bridged the gap between Tess and everybody else. And once that character dies, you can see it's only about survival mode. And with that, Tess is not trying to bond with anybody. She's not trying to perhaps talk about the past and maybe get some type of healing or anything. It's strictly about, how are we going to survive the night? Oh, that person died. Well, can you do this, that, and the third? Okay, I'm going to go over here and do this thing. Try not to die. And if they storm the house, pick up something and try to fight back. It's very much, I want to say the word pragmatic, but it's, I think the best way to put it is, there's a mix of recognizing that they don't really have much time to talk because these men are trying to kill them, all for some money they think is there. Yet at the same time, it's like, more could have been said and done so that these characters aren't just faces on the screen who sometimes get impaled by a bow and arrow. Overall, when it comes to Fear the Night, it's the type of film that, like quite a few of these random indie video on demand films you watch, it just disappears into the abyss of the vast ocean that is video on demand releases. Has a bit of a pop because it pops up on Netflix, Hulu, whatever, and then after that, it just disappears to the point that unless you're a fan of Maggie Q or one of the other actors in this, you would probably never discover that this exists.